Okay, it's going to be one of those shows. Welcome to Mike Dell's World, number 171 for December 15th, 2010.
Your guns and bring your friends. It is lots of fun to lose and to pretend. She is so overboard, stupidly self-assured, and I know that's a dirty word again. I'm the worst at what I do the best. For this lovely gift, sweet Jesus, I feel blessed. Cause our group's always been and will be till the end. A mosquito, my libido, and the rest. Oh, baby, with all the lights out, it is so much less dangerous. Here we are now, darling, entertain us, please. Oh, what else can I be? Cause I'm all of apologies. And I swear to you, I don't have a gun. I'm like a Pisces when I'm weak. I've been locked inside your heart-shaped box for weeks. I'm forever enticed by your priceless advice. You can come here doused in mud or soaked in bleach. I've just forgotten why I taste, but I guess it puts a smile upon my face. It was hard to find. Oh, whatever, never mind. I wish I could eat your cancer when it hates. Oh, baby, with all the lights out, it is so much less dangerous. Here we are now, darling, entertain us, please. I wish I was like you, cause you're easily amused. And I swear to you, I don't have a gun. Oh, Courtney, with all the lights out, it is so much less dangerous. Here we are now, darling, entertain us, please. We like all the pretty songs, and we like to sing along. Okay, maybe I just might have a gun.
You're listening to Mike on Mike Dell's World Podcast.
And that was the song called Smells Like Karen Carpenter by the Money Shot Cosmonauts from the Funny Music Project. And hey, welcome to Mike Dell's World. Sorry, I haven't podcasted a whole lot in the last month or so, as I explained over on the Unplugged feed. Just been kind of busy with other podcasts and other projects. And of course, this time of the year is always busy with all the holidays and whatnot. So, you know, whatever. Of course, I'm always apologizing. Put it this way, this is my personal blog/podcast. And, you know, I'll put it out whenever I can. But for the most part, it'll be weekly, sometimes very weekly. And I want to talk about my sponsor one more time. And then after this, I think I'm done with sponsors for a while. But it's Dr. Leonard Peikoff. Dr. Peikoff is recognized as the world's foremost authority on Ayn Rand's philosophy of objectivism. He has created a popular website that features weekly podcasts where he addresses questions asked by real people who are challenged with real problems and are looking for an objectivist opinion. And you can hear a lot more about that if you go check out Trucker Tom's podcast. He's really been getting into this objectivist philosophy. But also Dr. Peikoff's podcast is you know, I've been listening to it. It's very interesting. Most of his podcasts are, you know, little one-question snippets, but every once in a while he throws in one that's, 20 minutes long with several questions. But, you can hear him give practical answers to questions submitted every week. As the foundation of his responses, he uses objectivism. There's 4 to 6 questions on the big podcast and then, single questions on the other ones. I don't know. It's very interesting. And I also downloaded the Ayn Rand Atlas Shrugged novel on Audible. And that's 64 hours and then probably 20 hours into it now, finally. But like I said, it's a very interesting podcast. Whether you agree or disagree, that's up to you, but go check it out. You can submit your question or find new relevant topical podcasts every week at www.peekoff.com. That's peekoff.com, or just click the banner link at the top of my page at mikedell.com, and that banner will be there for the rest of the month. So it's right above the header there on my site. So I guess that takes care of the sponsors for this week. And let's see, if you've listened to Mike Dell Unplugged, and like I said, you can find all of my podcasts over at MikeDell.com, and there's either links or feeds or whatever, so you can subscribe to all of it. If you want to hear everything I do, you can subscribe to the Radio Mike Dell feed, and that includes What's Up With That, that includes Mike Dell Unplugged, Mike Dell Video, and Mike Dell's World. And I think that's it right now. I'm not doing any of the ham radio class podcasts right now. I am doing Geek of the North, and that'll also show up on Radio Mike Dell, so you can check that out. So, hey, what would a winter time or almost winter podcast at Mike Dell's World be without me talking about snow? Let's see, about 10 days ago, I put out a podcast on the Unplugged feed, which started out with the winter storm warning that we had for lake effect snow here in northern Michigan. And basically, it hasn't stopped since then. We've had 10 days of measurable snow here, and I wasn't ready for it. I think I'm almost ready for it. I've already had to plow the driveway twice. Now, last winter, the entire season last year, I only had to get the snowblower out 3 times, maybe 4 times. And one of those times, I got interviewed by the local TV station about why I would use a snowblower instead of a shovel. That wasn't very smart, but anyway, we have just had a crazy amount of snow here. I would say we probably had 1.5 feet so far. And, like I said, I've already had the snowblower out twice. Plus, my neighbor borrowed my snowblower and did my driveway too. That was nice of him. And so it's been plowed 3 times. And that's just crazy. We went from no snow and late start to winter to holy crap, we're in winter and there ain't a whole lot we can do about it. That's fine. Last weekend, Kathy and I went down to Grand Haven to her folks' place. We helped her dad and stepmom get their Christmas tree up. As you know, I went down to Texas in June to drive them home from Texas because, Kathy's dad is not doing so well. He's been rather ill, and he just turned 80 here in August. So, But he's not doing real great. He seems to be in pretty good spirits, but physically, yeah, he ain't doing so well. So hopefully this Christmas season will be a good and special one. And that's what we went down last weekend for. But to get back to the snow story, we came north on Sunday. And, you know, it's about 150 miles, the drive. Well, the last 50 miles of the drive was in blizzard conditions. And when I say blizzard, there's a definition of blizzard on Wikipedia, if you look that up. But I believe it's 50-mile-an-hour winds, and I don't know. There was something about it. But anyway, we ended up in whiteout conditions, driving 30 miles an hour all the way up from Cadillac, Michigan, which is roughly 50 miles south of here. And it was just crazy. And, you know, we get used to that kind of stuff up here, especially with the lake effect. You know, lake effect can do all kinds of crazy stuff. In the first part of the season, the lake effect tends to dump closer to shore. You know, and of course, where we live here is, you know, like I said, 500 yards, if that, from Lake Michigan. So we tend to get a lot of snow when the wind is out of the north or the north-northwest. If it goes northwest, then it kind of flies over us or whatever. But yeah, like I said, we've got a foot and a half here, and we're not used to that. On top of that, my stupid car, of course, one of the days it got cold, I went out there, and when I was in a hurry, I tried to open the door, and of course it was frozen shut, but instead of grabbing the edge of the door and pulling, I pulled on the door handle and broke the damn door handle, which, I don't know. But, you know, that car, it's got 215,000 miles on it, and like I said, I'm kind of getting the blues about it, and that sort of sucks, because, you know, I kind of like to drive a car as long as I can, but I think I'm getting to the limit. I'm going to buy a new door handle, and when I can find some warmish weather, or take it over to where I work and put it in the warehouse there and let it warm up so I can work on it, I'll dig in there and change the door handle. But basically, I have to take the inner door panel off and, you know, get through all that mechanisms and whatever there, and, you know, I don't know if it's worth it. But like I said, I definitely got the old car blues, which kind of makes me feel like I need a new car.
Let me tell you a little story about this problem with my car. It's old, it's gray, it's breaking down, and smokes like a cigar. It breaks down on the highway more than I can even say. I'd like to call a tow truck to haul the thing away. I'm over my limit, paying those AAA dues. I got the flat tire, traffic ticket, broke down automobile blues. Radiators radiating, antifreeze and mist. There's an Arab in my gas tank, an OPEC strategist. Carburetor's not carburetin'. Gas tank sprung a leak, alternator took a lunch break, and the battery is weak. I'm overextended, paying those AAA dues. I got the flat tire, traffic ticket, broke down automobile blues. Thank you.
my tires lost their traction, and my brakes, they lost their grip. The muffler's hanging backwards, the ragtop's got a rip. The windows all are broken, the dashboard needs some glue. My oil, it's been leaking, and my engine is just blue. I'm in collections, trying to pay my AAA dues. I got the flat tire traffic ticket, broke down on a mobile blues. My headlights, they are dying, the gas tank's leaking gas. Take it in for the inspection, but I know it never passed. I even tried to sell it for the price of a used tire. I couldn't get a dime for it, and I'm setting it on fire. I've got my notice, missing those AAA dues. I got the flat tire traffic ticket, broke down automobile blues. Now I'm heading down the highway with my brand new walking shoes. I ain't got no more headaches. Have you heard the latest news? Let my legs do all the walking since they took my car away. If you see me thumbing, pick me up and you will make my day. I got no more gas pains, no more AAA dues. No more flat tire traffic ticket, broke down automobile blues. Oh, drive it on, brother.
That was Mark W. Curran. It was called The Flat Tire Traffic Ticket, Broken Down Automobile Blues.
You're listening to Mike on Mike Dell's World, a show about nothing.
That's what she thinks. Anyway, that little break there when Kathy talked, it's actually 24 hours have passed. A little technical difficulty here. Seems that somehow one of my wires got knocked loose and I started getting a real bad buzz. But I think I've got the buzz taken care of. So we'll continue on here with Mike Dell's World number 171. But like I said, it's a day late, a dollar short. Actually, quite a few dollars short. But I know before the song there, I was talking about the old cars falling apart and all that, and me thinking about a new one. Of course, I go through these little bouts of new car syndrome every now and again. One car I've been looking at is the Ford Fiesta. And I know, well, at least people my age know that back in the 70s and 80s, when the Volkswagen Rabbit was actually fairly popular because of its gas mileage. And, of course, they came out with the diesel ones, and those even got better mileage. But Ford came out back then with a Rabbit lookalike. That was called the Fiesta, and it wasn't a very good car. But these new Ford Fiestas seem to be really nice. And, no, I'm not doing an ad for Ford like a lot of other podcasters do. Kind of wish I would. I'd love to have Ford sponsor me. In fact, not really a Ford guy, but I do own an old Ford F-150 rust bucket. And I'd be just tickled pink to drive a new Ford. But anyway, just sort of looking at it. One thing I did notice, our local Ford dealer, who shall remain nameless, but look up Ford dealer Traverse City, Michigan, figure out who it is. But local Ford dealer here, I sent an email, or not an email, but, filled out the little electronic form there on the Ford website saying, yeah, I'm kind of interested in the Fiesta. Yeah. So I'd like to get a stick shift vehicle, and they're one of the few out there that routinely make a stick shift, or at least the Fiesta comes in a stick shift, but that's because it's a world car, meaning it's available everywhere Fords are sold, rather than a special model for the UK and a special model for the US. I mean, of course there's some differences, but not terribly different. But anyway, I keep getting these automated messages from different salesmen, but none of them, you know, one of them asked me a bunch of questions. I answered all the questions, and he hasn't got back to me, so I don't know. I think I'm just going to have to go down there and test drive one of them once the roads dry out. Yeah, up here, you don't want to go test driving cars in the snow, you know, unless you're buying a big four-wheel drive and that's your thing, but... You know, I would rather drive one on a day when the roads are dry and can get it up to speed and all that good stuff. So we'll see. Definitely not in a hurry. So talking about holiday plans. Of course, I celebrate Christmas and got kind of a busy holiday schedule coming up. Of course, it's always kind of crazy right around Christmas time. My folks' anniversary is on New Year's Eve. And being as though I'm going to be 45 here pretty soon, this is going to be their 46th or 7th. Well, let me think about that for a minute. Yeah, this would probably be their 47th wedding anniversary. Wow. It's got 3 years to their 50th, and we'll have to have a party for that. But so New Year's Eve, we celebrate our my mom's side of the family's Christmas. We already did my dad's side of the family, as I explained in an earlier podcast, I think one of the unplugged episodes. And because, you know, all my dad's brothers and sisters like to go to Florida for the winter, and they wanted to get it over with, so we did it Thanksgiving weekend. And on the 24th, we do my mom's side of the family, a big dinner and get-together with all the kids and the kids' kids, and grandma's still around, and we have a good time with that. And then after the family all leaves, we have another little gift exchange with my folks and my wife and my sister and her kid, my nephew, Zachary. And we'll do that. And then Kathy and I will come home and get up early in the morning. Well, not too early, but we have to be on the road by like 10 o'clock. Heading to Grand Haven to spend Christmas afternoon with Kathy's side of the family. So, got a 150-mile drive, no matter what the weather is, go down there. But that's a fun time, you know. And I like this time of year. To add to the complications, where I work, we're getting a new large piece of equipment. The main large piece of equipment that I work with is being replaced during the week between Christmas and New Year's. And then the week after that, we got training. So during the week that they're replacing, it's a big digital printing press. During that week while they're replacing that, I'll still continue working my night shift for those 4 nights. Of course, we get Friday off for New Year's Eve, I'm done. Was it Wednesday morning? Yeah, I'm done. No. I'm done Thursday morning. There we go. So, but anyway, during that week, I'll be doing all the file maintenance and, I'll find something to do. I got a few projects that I need to wrap up, so that'll be good to get those done. And then the following week, the first week of January, I get to be on day shift for a week. I'm going to go in and train with the people from the manufacturer of the press to know how to do file prep for it. And it does a lot of funky, cool stuff. One of these days I'll do a video tour of where I work and what we do there, and I'm sure they would enjoy that too. Actually, if you I guess it'd be on Facebook. Yeah, if you're on Facebook, friends with me, look at my stream from a couple days ago, and there is a video from where I work showing the conventional press room through Just Labs magazine. You can also just go be a fan of Just Labs magazine on Facebook, and you could see that video. But that's kind of what I do for a living. I started talking about that I'm not going to buy any tech gadgets for family members and whatever for Christmas. I talked about that on Geek of the North, on the last episode of Geek of the North. And I think I'm going to stick to that. You know, although I had a little bit of an urge to buy my sister a tech toy, but she just got an iPhone, and she's fallen in love with Angry Birds. So have I, but I've finished all of the levels I can, and of course Angry Birds now has that advent calendar version that every day you get a new level up until Christmas. And anyway, I'm getting off track here. You know, I probably ought to just wrap this up and call it a podcast. Like I said, it's taken 2 days to get it out, and I did finally get the buzz fixed. But one thing I'm definitely not going to do is get anybody a razor. And to that end, I got one more song here. It's called the Electric Razor Blues.
Charge no more, no more. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more, no more. It used to hold a charge so long, but it don't no more, and that's so wrong. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. The ladies like the way my razor held a charge before. I said the ladies like the way my razor held a charge before. Held a charge for a year and a day. At least that's what the ladies say. But my electric razor don't hold a charge no more. I'm not stupid. You think the razor is a metaphor? I'm not stupid. You think the razor is a metaphor? Well, what you say is pure conjecture. Don't make me give you another lecture. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. I have sworn affidavits from the ladies that I'm actually speaking about my razor not holding a charge no more. I got sworn affidavits from the ladies. I'm actually speaking about my razor not holding a charge no more. No more. If you don't believe them, I say fine. Take it up with the law firm of Owens and Klein. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. If I were talking about something else, don't you think I could have come up with a better metaphor than a razor not holding a charge no more? No more. If I were talking about something else, don't you think I could have come up with a better metaphor than a razor not holding a charge no more? So many other things I could have used instead, so I'll say it till my face is red. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. The electric razor industry can get away with shoddy craftsmanship, because you can't sing about their products without people thinking you're singing about something else no more. No more. The electric razor industry can get away with shoddy craftsmanship, because you can't sing about their products without people thinking you're singing about something else no more. They get away with lies and deceit, and wouldn't let me return it though I kept the receipt. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. By listening to this song, you, the listener, implicitly agree that the singer is speaking about his razor, and any inference that he's speaking about something else will be considered defamation of character and libelous in a court of law. By listening to this song, you, the listener, implicitly agree that the singer is speaking about his razor, and any inference that he is speaking about something else will be considered defamation of character and libelous in a court of law. That's from the firm of Owens and Klein. They suggested that I add that line. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. No more. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more. And if I happen to be singing about something else, I'm gonna keep that info to myself. My electric razor don't hold a charge no more.
Now, I wonder if that includes electric beard trimmers. my electric clippers that I use to trim my beard don't hold a charge no more. But hopefully I'll be remedying that over the Christmas season. I've put in my request with Santa Claus, so we'll see what happens. Hey, if I don't get back to you before Christmas or whatever you celebrate over the holidays, I'd say Happy Christmas, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, all that good stuff. I should be back before then. Got a few irons in the fire. Tomorrow I'll be recording What's Up With That with Jim Farley. I believe we're scheduled to do that tomorrow morning. And that should be nice. The following Friday, I'm going to be doing Geek of the North. For the time being, I'm going to alternate Geek of the North and What's Up With That. So we'll keep them coming. Plan to do a little bit more phone casting over at Mike Dell Unplugged. And some video stuff that from the summer. You know, I figured the middle of the winter is a good time to start playing the summer videos from the really hot outside Sugar Island Music Fest. Got probably 3 or 4 songs taped from the stage there that I'm going to put out as video over at MikeDell.com and click on the video feed. Of course, all the different various Mike Dell stuff can be had at Radio Mike Dell, which is at MikeDell.com, and click on the Radio Mike Dell feed, and that's pretty much everything I do I put into that feed. All right, enough pimping. Y'all have a great week. hopefully we'll catch you next week. If not, we'll catch you when we do. You can catch me later.
Rat hole, fool.